Alright guys, so we are going to paint this fun little pumpkin today. You should have a big brush, a medium brush, and a small brush. You should also have a paper towel or toilet paper roll. It's all the same. Promise they're clean. And then on your palette, you should have white, brown, orange, and black. So to start out, we're going to paint the entire canvas brown. So how I'm going to do that is first I'm going to take my big brush and I'm going to paint the whole canvas white. And I'm just going to kind of glop it on there because we're going to make it brown, lighter brown. So just cover your whole canvas in white. It doesn't have to be perfect. Make sure you get your edges. Alright, so the whole canvas is white. Then same brush, you're going to grab some brown. And you're just going to make some lines in there, all over, and then you're going to go back in and blend that in with your white, and it's going to make a brown background. Again, make sure you go all the way to your edges, and just blend until you're happy, all the way across your canvas. You want it to be streaky, it gives it a little effect there. Upside down so I can reach the other side here. Add a little bit more white. I don't think I had enough paint. It's drying up on me. So you can always add more white if it starts to dry up and doesn't blend. Add a little bit more brown down on this end. Alright, so you can do your edges too. Alright, so you have your whole canvas covered now. You should. If not, I'll go ahead and press pause and catch up. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to use that paper towel roll. So you're going to, on one end it's going to be brown, so grab some brown paint on your brush and just kind of dab it around the edges of the paper towel roll, just like that. And then you're just going to stamp your canvas, and it's going to give you these fun brown circles all over. And you want to focus on the edges, not necessarily the middle, because that's where you're going to put your pumpkin. But you want to have, you know, little half circles showing too. You don't want to look like you did it after you did the pumpkin. So, there are my circles in brown. And then I'm going to do the same thing in white. So I'm going to wash off my brush here. And then we're going to paint the other end of the tube white. Just kind of dab on your paint there. And then do some white circles too. And again, they're all random, which I know people have a problem with random. But just let it go, have fun with it. Need a little bit more paint on that one. Put a few more on here. Alright, and then there are my white circles stamped. So that is it for right now. We're going to let this dry. The background and the circles both need to dry. So we'll come back in about 15-20 minutes and we'll start step two. Background should be pretty dry. Most of your dots or circles should be dry. If they're not, they'll be okay. So we're ready to move on to the pumpkin. So big brush, we're going to grab that white paint. Yes, we're making a white pumpkin. We want the orange to really pop on the background. So we're going to do it in white first. So basically to make a pumpkin, you're making a C one way, a C the other way, and then you're adding little humps at the top and the bottom. That way it looks more like a pumpkin. So it's a lot easier than you would think. And remember, pumpkins come in all shapes and sizes. So once you have the outline of your pumpkin, go ahead and fill it all in white, and you're going to go from top to bottom as you're painting, because you know that's the way the lines on the pumpkin would be. Some of my brown was not completely dry. as you can see, but it blends in, so no worries there. And you're still going to see some of those dot or the circles through your pumpkin, but you're not going to really pay attention to it because the focus is going to be on everything else. So don't worry about that either. All right, so your pumpkin should be all white. Then you're going to go back over it in orange. Same brush, no need to clean it. The white will help blend and add color there. So you're just going to do the same thing with orange now. See how it's got some different contrast with the orange and the white? That's what you want. Orange you want your pumpkin is totally up to you. If you want that to dry and do another coat of orange to make it brighter, you can do so. I'm going to leave mine the way it is because I think it looks okay being that light. So once you have the desired color of your pumpkin, you're then going to use your big brush still and grab a little bit of brown. And not that kind of brown. And you're going to make the contrast lines, like where the pumpkin veins would be. I think that's what they're called. And so you're going to make those, and then you're just going to kind of blend them in. That's why we didn't clean off our brush. And put those wherever you want. Okay, so our pumpkin has definition to it. Go ahead and stick your brush in the cup of water we're done with the big one. You don't need to really clean it. And then we're going to use our medium-sized brush. So you're going to grab some black paint, and we're going to make the stem of the pumpkin. So I think it's fun to have this little curl. So what you're going to do is you're going to start out on one side. You're going to come up and curl. Okay. And then you're going to take the other side and just kind of follow it and knead it. Okay. So then you'll fill that in. A little bit thicker. You don't worry about making it perfect that first time around. Just trying to get the shape. And you kind of want to follow the line of your pumpkin swirl when you go fill this in. So it's going to kind of come up and down. And then you're going to fill that in. That way it looks like an actual pumpkin, not just some black things to kind of do. And if you're going to step is still wet like mine, you can just do a second coat. Not to worry. Okay. And then at the bottom, I like to do a little bit of black too, just kind of add some shape to it, maybe cleans up if you made any mistakes. So I'm just going to kind of outline the bottom of my pumpkin as well. Still with that medium-sized brush and black paint. Canvas. So come back in about 15, 20 minutes when that's dry. Just dry a little bit. We're gonna do a few more things to it. So with that small paintbrush, grab some white paint and we're gonna add just some fun little white circles all around your background of your canvas. Again, it just makes it more fun and takes away from any of those imperfections you might have. So you can add those anywhere. Alright, so however many you want. And then you can just wipe off your paintbrush. You don't have to clean it fully. Because then we're going to use the end of the paintbrush. You're going to stick it in your brown paints. And we're going to add little polka dots to the stem up here. So you're just going to add little dots. And again, that just kind of makes it fun. It kind of coordinates the white dots too. It makes them look like they go together. Alright, so there is that. A couple of my dots are dripping. That's why we paint flat here at the studio. And then you're going to be done if you want it to look like just a pumpkin, or if you want, you can do your family's initial in the middle, like the first letter of your last name. So you can do that too. I'm not going to do that because I don't need to make another G for my family. I already have one on the wall. But I think the curly letters look the best, so if you need any help with those, you can go and ask someone or look up on your phone or whatnot for some samples of fonts. So you can do that, and if you decide to do that, that will be your last step. But if you are not going to do that, you're done. So your final step is to sign your name at the bottom of your canvas. So with that small paintbrush, make sure you add your initials down in the corner, or your name, or the date, whatever you want to sign. Ta-da, we have a finished piece of artwork. Thank you guys for coming out, and I hope you have a great afternoon.